Hi. My name is Savio Chen. I'm the president of the U.S. Pan-Asian Chamber of Commerce of the Northeast Region. And today we have a good panel for you. And instead of me telling them who they are, I'll let them to tell you who they are. So they'll tell you about their title, the name of the company, and what they do, and then we can start the panel. So Paul?
Oh, sure. My name is Paul Taravella. I'm an industrial specialist with the U.S. Small Business Administration, Government Contracting Division, located here in New York, Federal Plaza. And our office basically takes care of the region stretching from Maine to New Jersey, including Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands. The purpose of the SBA Government Contracting Division is to assure that the small business community receives its fair share of the government contracting dollar. And we do that through a number of programs. One program is the Prime Contracts Program. Through the Prime Contracts Program, the SBA reviews solicitations coming out of various government buying offices to assure that solicitations that can be performed by small business are set aside for small business participation only, which gives the small business community a huge leg up in competition over large businesses. We also have a program called the Subcontracting Program, through which when any large business receives a federal contract in excess of $550,000 or $1 million for construction, they're required to file a subcontracting plan under that contract, wherein they set goals for subcontracting to small businesses, small disadvantaged businesses, women-owned small businesses, what are known as hub-zone firms, better-known small businesses, and service-disabled better-known small businesses. And the SBA monitors the large business compliance to these plans to assure that the large business gives small business their fair opportunity to compete for the subcontracting role under those large federal contracts. We also have a program called the Formal Size Determination Program. You'll probably understand that you have programs that set aside contracts strictly for small businesses. You may have situations where large businesses may try to sneak into those contracts by posing as small businesses, okay? And in order to cure that situation, the SBA has a protest program where if the contracting officer or another small business competing on that contract feels that one of the competitors is in fact a large business, they can protest that firm's status to the SBA. We'll do a separate investigation into that company. If we find out that the firm is in fact a large business, we'll bar them from attempting to receive any more set-asides in federal procurement. We also have a program called the Certificate of Competency Program. And this involves strictly prime contracts under the federal government. If you bid on a federal government contract as a small business and you are the low bidder and the contracting officer feels that you cannot perform under that contract for any of a number of reasons, possibly because of lack of financial capability, lack of technical capability, lack of proper quality assurance system, et cetera, the small business has a right of appeal of that negative decision of the contracting officer under the COC program. You can apply to SBA for a certificate of competency. We again will do an investigation of the firm to determine your firm's capability. And if SBA feels that your firm can, in fact, perform on that federal contract, we will issue a COC, which would then force the contracting officer to award that contract to your firm. So in a nutshell, those are the types of programs, and hopefully I can give you further details later on.
Well, before we go on, our session is to talk about how do you get contract, procurement contracts from large corporations as well as the government and state agencies. So we have different experts in this panel here that address different areas from the state government side, from the SBA side, some of the small corporations, entrepreneurs who are getting a lot of contracts as a minority Asian companies. So if you are Asian or women minority owned and operated company, you actually have an advantage to earn get contracts from both large corporations as well as the federal and state agencies. So our panel talk about all these things, as we go on. So Shirley?
My name is Shirley Leung. I'm the Director of Economic Development for Manhattan Chamber of Commerce. And we have different programs to work with MWBEs, we call it, and also to guide them to do the procurement process. Because a lot of small businesses, once they hear about the government contract, they're very interested in them, which is really a good market for that. But it's such a tedious process to navigate through the process. I think that is part of the reason that all of us are here today. So we have different programs on that. A little bit of my background is I used to work for New York State Economic Development for many years. I was the one to go out to certify people. So kind of know the inside out from the government side of how to relook at a small business and get them certified and how to help them. And also, I still work on the one-on-one with businesses and the SBDC program to go out to work with business directly, because each business has their own niche. How you approach getting to the market, or they are certified, they don't get any contracts, and they want to get help. So I'm working under those programs to really go out and hands-on to work with business. So I will talk about a little bit later where you can find these opportunities, from the small one to the big one.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Shirley. Well, Shirley actually has been in this area for a long time, and she really is a heavyweight, not in terms of physical size-wise, but in terms of experience-wise. She's very knowledgeable on this area, so she'll talk more about that later on. Dan?
Sure. My name is Daniel Park, and I'm the founder and CEO of Eclaro International. We are an IT services firm. We started out doing a lot of software, then moved to staff augmentation, and now we do a lot of offshore work in the Philippines as well as in China for the most part. But I guess since we do some government work, but certainly I probably lack the expertise that my cohorts here have on this side. So I'll just talk about the commercial side. I think in addition to my role, obviously, in having my own company, I also work actively with another nonprofit called the National Minority Supply Development Council. And in that regard, I serve as a sort of an MBE chair, Minority Business Entrepreneur chair for that group for the New York region. So I'm very familiar with taking advantage of sort of taking the opportunity that's given to us as minority owners within corporate procurement. There's a whole world of supplier diversity. Some of you probably are familiar with it. And I've been doing this for over 10 plus years, utilizing it, and it's been very successful for me. And it's actually led to some of the government work that these folks certainly have more expertise than I do. So that's the message why.
Well, Dan is very humble. He's the owner and operator for a $40 million size IT firm. And over the years, he has won a lot of good awards, you know, besides chairing the NWBE program. Now, you will hear a lot of the acronyms we're going to throw out to you. So if you're not sure what it means, don't be afraid to raise your hand and ask, because, you know, if you don't ask, we will not know that you know. When they say about MBE, that means Minority, you know, Business Enterprise, right?
Yes.
And MWBE, which is Minority Women Business Enterprise. So there are all kinds of acronyms, alphabet soups to throw around. So if you're not sure the meaning of that, please feel free to ask. We're here to answer your questions and decipher these situations. So we got a good, you know, mix of expert here. And myself, I'm the Northeast President for the U.S. Pan-Asian American Chamber of Commerce, the country's largest Pan-Asian chamber with over 8,000 members. We have 6 chapters in the country. And our job is to go out there and educate and certify our minority companies and help them get contracts. So we're all doing similar things. You know, we all try to help and facilitate that process. And if you're new to this, it may be a little bit overwhelming because it's a lot of information. But the good news is you have 4 experts here, 3.5, I'm only half an expert, that really can answer a lot of your questions and guide you you won't waste a lot of time to go to the wrong information. But if you do it right, I can tell you that it's very, very helpful. We have helped, for example, one of our members who is Asian minority-owned companies, and who has been in business for over 20 years and quite successful in his own right, but he's never been to using this kind of program to get contracts. And at first, he was a little bit skeptical, say, hey, you know, I'm not sure I need to be certified.